month was again one of my very best months full-time reselling, so let's tell you all about it. Hi everyone, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Erlia, otherwise known as Marzi Chick, and in today's video, I wanted to go over my monthly analytics for everything in Poshmark and across my business. If you guys are new here, I'm a full-time reseller, and this whole channel is just dedicated to business tips, thrifting, reselling, and everything in between. So if you guys like the sound of that, make sure that you hit the little subscribe button down below, as well as the notification bell, and give this video a big thumbs up for the YouTube algorithm. And lastly, before we get into today's video, I just wanted to warn you, although these are my most popular videos, that these videos can be a bit lengthy. So if you're just looking for one specific thing, say my what sold, there are timestamps in the description below for you guys to kind of hop around, whether you do want to know the what sold, my numbers, or anything like that. So a lot changed over the past month, and I kind of wanted to get into that today. So first thing being, I was finally monetized on YouTube, which was very exciting. This is something I've been waiting for a little bit here. But the second thing is that Poshmark came out with its own dashboard, which I actually wanted to show you guys today, but they don't let you hop from month to month yet, only by year. So unless I go back in time and screenshot last month and show you guys where the dips were, I cannot show you those things today. So I'm super sorry about that because I was hoping to show you guys some of my boards, but I realized since I didn't screenshot it from last month, I won't be able to show you that this month. And lastly, I have been working on a project for probably the last month and a half, so I'm hopefully unveiling that soon. I will see, but that is a new exciting thing coming to my business as well. I am going to be going over my spreadsheet first though today, just so you guys can get a feel for what my numbers were this past month. They absolutely were better than any other month I've had reselling, and especially full-time reselling, which is so exciting. So firstly, the most important thing that I did this past month that I have been taking way more seriously is cross-listing. This video is not sponsored whatsoever, but I know that I've been using List Perfectly for about over a year now, just cross-listing things here and there to Mercari and eBay. If you guys have been watching this channel for a little bit, you know that I no longer sell on Mercari just because I don't get a lot of sales there and I feel like it's not really worth my time anymore. But I have seriously been cross-listing to eBay because they have a lot more active users than Poshmark has. So I know that there's a lot of potential on eBay to make more sales than there is on Poshmark. So that's kind of why I have been cross-listing my items between the two. So if you guys want to try out List Perfectly, like I said, I have been using it for over a year and it has made such a big difference. It will definitely pay off for you guys. So if you guys want to try List Perfectly, it definitely pays for itself. And I have a little code down below. You can just use my code MARZICHICK for 30% off your first month if you want to try it. If not, there are no risks involved and you can definitely cancel. So if you guys are really serious about making more sales, I absolutely would recommend cross-listing, and that is definitely what made the most difference in this past month, I would say. But the second most thing that I would say that made a difference is actually you guys. So having this community here on YouTube has made such a big difference because I did finally get monetized on this channel, which for some of you might be a small change in revenue, but for me, that is a huge change in revenue since I am already putting so many hours into this channel, and to know that it's paying off is such a blessing. So I did just want to say a thank you to everyone that subscribes to this channel, that watches my videos. I so appreciate it, and you guys make so much more of a difference than you realize. So I have my laptop here, and I'm going to be pulling up my spreadsheet so you guys can see exactly what my numbers were. So if I show you guys my screen, I have been adding a ton of new things to my spreadsheet, and they're not totally completed yet. So if you guys see a whole bunch of empty numbers or random colors, you guys know exactly what's going on here. I'm hoping to have an updated version of my spreadsheet for sale. But again, Poshmark did just come out with their own little dashboard for you guys to look at that's completely free. eBay has one as well, and I think Mercari has one as well. So you guys definitely don't need a spreadsheet, but I personally love Excel and I love logging my numbers. There's something just super satisfying about it. So I do have my own spreadsheet that I've designed just to look at my own analytics because I think of it more as a game. If I can just plug things in and look at how I am progressing towards my goals, I find that really exciting. So if you guys are the same, hopefully this will be up for sale soon again with the updated version. But let's talk a little bit about my platforms and how they've been performing. So just looking at Poshmark, Poshmark is definitely my primary selling platform still. And I made 136 sales on Poshmark with an average sales price of $46.79. I know a majority of you do sell on Poshmark, so you already know this. Poshmark takes 20% of your earnings and their final fees. So that means your profit per item is going to be lower than any other platform. So when I looked at my average profit per item on Poshmark, it was $24.56, so just around $25. That number used to be a lot lower for me, but I have been focusing on $30 and up items for profit now, not even thinking about items that could make me $30, but just profit me $30. So that change in mindset has really changed how much profit I've been making as well. After that is eBay. I ended up making 14 sales on eBay, and my average sales price on eBay was $90.25. That is a huge, huge difference. I don't really know why this is. I think it's mostly because I cross-list items that are much higher in value to eBay, and I usually have a better result on there. But I do have some pie charts on here that I'm going to be throwing up here soon as well with the profits compared to total sales. I have a huge chunk of profit from eBay, but I only made 14 sales on that platform. That happened last month as well, so that's really why I've been trying to build a base in eBay, because I see a lot more success on eBay in terms of profit than I do on Poshmark. And also, because eBay takes a lesser fee than Poshmark does, my average profit per item on eBay was $64.33. Again, that is a huge jump. And that to me is why I've been pushing so much towards eBay, because I've seen that eBay is a huge chunk of my profits without me selling as many items. I don't really know why this is. I think it's just because I've been cross-posting items that have a higher value, but then again, people are buying it for that higher value on eBay and they aren't on Poshmark. You know, I see a lot more consistent sales on Poshmark for me, even when I'm daily listing right now, and honestly, I think it's just because I have a smaller amount of inventory to list than other sellers, and I have to take some time to build up my eBay store. But I will say this is really promising for me, and this is what's really making me go towards eBay with an open mind. And that's also why I'm telling you guys to get cross-listing. Just on eBay in gross revenue, I made $1,263, and my total earnings in profit from eBay were $900 and some cents. That is huge, guys. You don't even realize it, and that's just from cross-posting things from Poshmark that I had already had listed to eBay. So if you guys are looking for that next push, definitely be doing this. It makes a huge difference. And even if you think eBay is intimidating, there are a ton of different resources here on YouTube that you guys can look up and look into things if you don't know them already. And on Poshmark, my gross revenue was $5,952, and my profit was $3,364. Looking at my totals here, that means that my total revenue, not profit, was $7,215.50. That is huge. That's the most I've ever made. And additionally, that means that my profit is most likely the best as well. And it was. My total profit for the month of October was $4,535. That is a huge leap for me, especially since last month I couldn't even reach the 4,000 mark, because as a full-time seller, I feel like I should be able to do that. This is really promising, really encouraging to be able to have that leap in my profits and to be able to sustain that. You guys know I've only been trying to make small, sustainable steps toward this number, so I'm really excited about this. I'm really encouraged about it. And you know, I don't think that it was anything crazy that I've done from this past month. I think it is all about consistency, cross-posting, and also having this new revenue stream from YouTube. Now onto the what sold portion of this video. I have tried to make this section a little bit longer because obviously this month's sales were a lot better than any other month I've made. So today I have my three worst sales first, because I think it's a reality check for all of us to know what is selling poorly for other sellers. Not everything is a super, super great sale. But then after that, I will have 20 best sales this month, because again, my sales were just better than any other month I've had. And I think it'll show some university and things that are selling for me, as well as platforms that are selling for me right now. So that way you guys can pick up these items as well when you find them. So the first worst sale that I had this past month was something that I lost money on, and it was this animal print Urban Outfitters pants. I bought these at a TJ Maxx like over a year ago, and they were $9.99, so they were $10. And for some reason, these just never moved for me. So these ended up having an offer on them finally, and the offer was for $14. So I ended up losing 30 cents on this item. And that is the reason why I'm mentioning it. I did lose money on this, although it was only 30 cents, and this was the only item this month that I lost money on. This is just something I never want to happen. And at this point, I was just, you know, let's get this item out of my closet. I don't want it anymore. So I did take the offer and just said goodbye to this item. This month, I decided not to only show my monetary worst items, but also some different things that I think you guys should be aware of. So the second worst sale here was not my monetarily worst sale necessarily, but it was just kind of the nail in the coffin for why I will no longer be selling on Flip for consignment. Again, I am totally open to doing consignment for good clients, and I would happily do so, but Flip has just not been the best experience for me because people are usually trying to send in items that they've already tried to resell themselves. This item in particular is an Avenue blouse, and I had told the customer originally that I didn't want to take this item because it wasn't going to sell for that much, and they kind of said, you know, I would really like you to take this item, and I ended up caving and taking it anyways. So I ended up taking an offer on this item for $7, and I ended up only making, I think, 50 cents on this item. So yeah, I would not recommend selling on Flip, especially because the clients I've gotten on there are not the best, I would say. I have had some good clients on Flip, but I think I'm just going to be consigning it myself from now on because I feel like a lot of their rules, especially with the Poshmark fees, are not worth it. You're only making about 10 to 30% profit on each item, which I don't think is a lot, and I don't think that it's enough for the amount of time that it takes to photograph all of those items. So like I said, this is definitely just the nail in the coffin for Flip for me. You can try it out yourselves. I mean, I would recommend you guys try out anything yourselves just to see if it works for you. But for this item in particular, not worth my time. And you guys are gonna be like, Erly, what? But seriously, this item I'm adding to my worst sales this month because I thought it was gonna go for so much more than it did. So this Lush Tack Fancy sweater is one that I wore in a previous video, if you guys remember it. I had actually sourced this online on ThredUp, and I paid $130 for it because they said it only had light material wear. When I got it in the mail, I was like, oh, this is cute, and I hung it up, and I was all ready to, you know, photograph it, and then I realized it had a ton of pilling, number one, but then number two, it had a stain on the back of one sleeve. So I realized that it was a paint stain, so I couldn't get it out, and I don't have the tools necessary right now living where I am to go out and get the remover for the paint, and I was also scared about the color of the item, about removing the color then too, so I just decided to leave it. I paid $130 for the item, and I only ended up selling it for $187. I feel like if this was in better condition, like I'd hoped it had been in, it would have sold for more and I would have made more of a profit on it. But I only ended up making $19.60 on this item, so just under $20. That's not bad for a profit per item, but since I paid up for $130 for this item, I was just like, oh, this is such a bad sale. But that's why I wanted to highlight it, because not every sale that you pay up for is also going to sell super hot. And because of the condition, when I got this offer, I was just like, you know what? I'm gonna move it because I don't wanna wait any longer hoping for $10 more profit on the item. Just because, you know, I did pay a lot for that and I'd rather just recoup my investment and put it towards other items. So those are my worst sales of the month. Let's hop into my top 20 best sales. We're going to be working backwards here to my best sales. So my best sales are going to be a little bit toward the end. So my 20th best sale, if I'm going to say that right, are these UGG Noe boots. So I actually ended up picking these up at the Nordstrom Rack sale. This was their sale for 40% off women's shoes. So when I picked up these boots, I paid around $30 for them, which I thought was really good for an UGG combat boot. And I ended up selling them for $90, which means that I made a profit of $42 on these pair of shoes. These sold within one day. So I was really excited about these. These were actually brand new in the box as well. So I did get to ship out the box with the item. Triumph. Absolutely stunning shoes. I really actually liked this style more than the Doc Martens style because I like the buckles and the laces. I will say they're classic like 2010 boots that you think of when you think of UGG don't always go as well, but leather boots go really well, and of course combat boots are really in style right now. After that was this red suede Blink NYC jacket. This was stunning. I found this in a local buy sell trade store, and actually this one in particular was priced up a lot, and I think it was just because it was a small store and all the inventory was pretty old. So when I saw this item and the price, I was just like, you know what, I'm gonna bite the bullet and try it, because the comps on this looked around 160 and I wasn't exactly sure. So I actually ended up paying $39.50 for this item, but it was brand new with tags. And again, anything leather just like outperforms any other thing that I list. So I actually ended up taking an offer on this for $105, even though that was really below the comped value of this item. I still made a decent profit on it. I sold this on Poshmark and ended up making $44.50 on this item after all of their fees, which I consider to be really decent. And you know, I'm not going to be waiting any longer. I think I had this listed also for like under a few days and it sold, so I'll take it, and I'll take that sale. A fast sale is better than a slow sale. I think that I am one of those sellers that definitely takes the faster sales over the long-term sales. So obviously if I know an item is worth way more than the value, say someone lowballs me for like $100 less than it's worth, I'm not going to be taking that offer. But if something sells like this for, you know, $40 under the comped value or something, I'm just like, I'm going to take it, because if I paid a decent price for it and I know that that can pay for my bills this next month, I'm absolutely going to take it. After that was something, if you guys watch my thrift hauls, this was in my thrift haul from the bins. This was an Avec Les Filets oversized moto jacket in black. This also was really, really cute. It did have some wear on it, but I ended up getting an offer on it for $60. Absolutely insane to me that I found this in the bin. So this was $350 by weight in the bins, and that means that my profit on this item was $44.50 as well. So this was kind of a tie with the last one in terms of profit. I will take this kind of sale any day. Any day that I can find in the bins, yes. So if there's a trend in anything that I'm gonna be talking about, it is that leather is back in. Coats and jackets are selling as well now, and also I've been selling a lot of leggings right now, so athleisure as well, as you guys are gonna see. This next sale was a Year of Ours football legging. I believe that these are sold on Carbon 38. And I ended up paying $9 for this item at a buy sell trade store because I didn't know what it was. When I looked up comps on these, it looked really good, so I did take it. And this sat a little bit longer than I thought it would, but it ended up selling for $70. And this was just a buy it outright. This was a stellar sale for me at a $45.50 profit. I'm so hoping that this customer loves their item. The next sale here, we're getting up there, was a pair of Nike Air Jordans. These were in a bigger size. These sat forever. I've had these since the summertime here, and these ended up coming from the bin. So I think I paid around $4 for these, and they ended up selling on eBay for $60. So the minute I got this offer again, I was like, I'm taking it, it's going. So yeah, I think it's just because these were a bigger women's size that they didn't sell as fast as other Nike shoes I've had in my closet. But even so, I thought that these were a great sale and they profited me $48.20. So that is a decent profit for me and I'm not going to be complaining. This next sale had such a sweet buyer. Oh my gosh. So I think this buyer ended up putting an offer in on these mules from Sorrel, and these I ended up finding in a thrift store. These were $7.50 and they ended up paying $70 for these. These were spotless, like absolutely so pretty, and there was nothing wrong with them. They were pre-distressed as well, but this buyer was so cute. And she was so excited about these and she left me the nicest love note. So girl, if you're watching this, I appreciate you so much. Thank you so much. And I'm hoping that you love these. Okay, 14 down on the list are these Rag and Bone booties. These are the Newberry 2 booty. These I found in a buy sell trade store locally, and they had underpriced these because the logo on the inside was pretty small. These I paid $14 for and I ended up selling them for $80. That means that I made a total profit of $50 on these booties. These also fit me, so these are hard to get rid of, But when these ended up selling, I immediately took it. I believe that I relisted these before they ended up selling because I listed them over the summertime. And obviously people aren't looking for booties in the summertime here, but right now I know I've been selling a lot of sweaters and booties. So these went and I'm so happy to see them go again. These were so pretty. And if no one had bought these, I definitely would have kept these for myself. The next item is also an item that sat for me and it ended up selling on eBay, and they were these Levi's Made and Crafted jeans. Made and Crafted is a higher end label from Levi's, and I'm gonna say on Poshmark it might not sell for that much, but on eBay at least, I don't know if this one was just because it was new with tags, but the Made and Crafted did go a lot higher than the ones that I have listed on Poshmark. So if you have any of the Made and Crafted jeans from them, definitely make sure that you have listed them on eBay. These were the barrel crop jeans, so they're kind of like a baggy wider leg jean with a high rise, and they also came with this like little leather tie belt. So cute. These ended up selling for $75 and $10.80 shipping. And I ended up finding these at the buy sell trade store for $15. And after all of that, that means that I made $50.25 on the sale, which I thought was really, really good. I do have a cap. Like I said, I try to stay $30 and over now in profit because I find that that's the best way for me to make more hourly and also to raise my profits overall. So this was an excellent sale. This item got so many likes on it in a small amount of time. I believe I sold these within a couple days. And these are a Doc Martin Chelsea boot. They're in a larger size, but they are a vegan leather. I ended up paying $63 for these online. I paid like a bunch of them in bulk because I ended up finding them. And they sold for $145, which means that my profit on these ones were $53, which is exactly where I wanted them to be. If not, I thought they were going to do a little bit less and I was going to be fine with that. But $53 is an excellent profit as well. So absolutely will take those. And these also went to a really sweet buyer. The next sale for me was this gorgeous Vanessa Mooney romper. This was in a rare style and pattern, so I ended up paying $28 for this at the buy sell trade store, and it sold on eBay for $110, which means that I made $69.70 on this sale. The next sale was at the end of the month here, and I was so excited about these selling. These are a pair of UltraCore leggings, and I ended up picking these up for $6, and they ended up selling for $98. That means that my total profit on just these one pair of leggings was $72. This was a great sale for me and I was really, really excited. This was a full price sale, which happens very rarely for me. So yeah, really, really excited about this sale. The next two sales are on Poshmark and they are both Old Gringo sales. So this first one is an Old Gringo embroidered cowboy boot and the leather was a little bit distressed on these. I paid $40 at the buy sell trade store for these, which was up a little bit more than I'm used to, but I loved the floral embroidery on these. They were so fun. I have seen other people sell these for more, but I purposely wanted to sell mine a little bit faster, so I did drop the price. I ended up getting an offer on these for $150 and I did take it, so that means that I made $80 on the sale. After that was another pair of Old Gringos. I found these at a separate buy sell trade store for $35, and I believe they are their off-brand, so it's OG by Old Gringo. I also sold these for $150. That means that I made $85 on these, so both boots were a really great find. Cowboy boots are definitely back in for the fall here. Going along with the boot trend, so these were a gorgeous pair of Freebirds that I sold on eBay, and they were called the Apex boots. These are purposely distressed. I found these in another buy sell trade store for $30. I'm sure that the store knew what they were, but they didn't know how to price them. I sold them for $140 on eBay. Although I did have to clean them up, I did take this offer because that means I made $91.80 on eBay, which I thought was a fabulous profit for these boots. After that, this sale was so surprising to me. I had actually put this on Instagram. I put it on my Poshmark and it didn't sell yet. And the minute I cross-listed this, within a day it sold. It was this Brody cashmere heart sleeve sweater. This was so soft and so cute. This sold full price for $128. I paid $15 for this and it was flawless, which means that I made $96.36 on this sale. I thought that this was amazing, especially since it was under 1 pound. I could ship it pretty fast and easily too. So this sale was just definitely out of the water for me this past month. Coming into my top five sales here, the first one that we have was actually yesterday that I sold this. So I'm currently filming this on November 1st so you guys can get this video really fast. And I mentioned this one on my Instagram as well. This was an Anika Chu dress. I picked this up at another buy sell trade store and I paid $18 for this. I ended up selling it yesterday for $150. That means that I made $102 on this dress. And again, this is an easy shipper for me. This was such a stunning little baby doll dress, and I know that this is much less than the retail cost of this item, so I'm so excited to get this item out of my closet and to its buyer. After that, the next sale here was on eBay. This one was definitely a lower offer than I wanted to sell this item for, but I did let it go anyway. This is my second time finding a Fear of God piece, and I actually found this one also in a buy sell trade store for $11. And I listed it for $200 because previously I knew they were in really high demand when I first found them. That was a few years ago. Now there's dedicated sellers to just Fear of God like there are Nike. And I believe this actually went to one of them. I'm almost positive that the seller is going to resell this item, but that is totally fine because I made a huge profit on it. I made $102.10, so that was a great sale for me overall. After that was a Veronica Beard dress that I got from a buy sell trade store. This one still had the tags on it, and I ended up paying $36 for this one, and it sold for $199 on an eBay offer. That means that I made $137.13 on this item. I will say that this one had a little bit of a more difficult buyer because they wanted it within the next few days, so I did have to upgrade the shipping. Just for all of my sellers out there, know that some customers are getting a little bit pushy about ship times because things are taking a lot longer to ship than they normally would, so you might have to pay up for shipping labels more than you usually would have to. So this, regardless, was still a great sale for me, and I will take a $100 plus sale any day. After that, if you guys watch any of my other videos as well, this was also in a thrift video. I found these online, and these are the Golden Goose Starden sneakers. I paid $180 for these online, and they ended up selling for $403, which is great. These are a limited edition style, and they're really hard to find online, and I think that they retailed for around $600 or so dollars. These were pretty much pristine on the bottom, so I knew that they were barely ever worn. These were also a larger women's size, so I understood that they might be harder to sell, but I did pick them up anyway. That means that on these ones, I made $142.40 on Poshmark. Excellent sale, nothing to be said here. I believe that these sold within 1 week. And the final and best sale that I made this past October was an international sale on eBay. So if you haven't opened your international sales yet, definitely do, especially for the holidays. This was a 360 cashmere Aztec cardigan that I modeled, and I ended up paying $20 for this at the buy sell trade store, and it was new with tags from the rack. And it sold for $198. That means that I made $152.26 on this order. The buyer was so, so sweet, and I hope that they absolutely love it. So soft. This was just one of those dream items that you hope to find. Those were my best and worst sales from this past October. If you guys liked this video, make sure that you give it a little thumbs up down below to support my channel. And make sure that you're also subscribed to see my progress from this month to the next month. I will see you guys in my next one. Bye.